Today's class is Nutrition in Surgery, Part 2. Last class we saw methods of nutrition, parenteral nutrition and enteral nutrition. Today we will discuss about these two in detail. Parenteral nutrition. Parenteral nutrition means the daily feeding are given to the patient through vein. Indications for parenteral nutrition. Infant is when unable to or should not receive food or liquid by mouth, when enteral nutrition is impossible. Poorly tolerated oral or enteral feeding. Indicated conditions. Severe diarrhea, Crohn's disease, ulcerative colitis, surgery related to short bowel syndrome, burns, malnourished oncology patients, renal or hepatic failure, malnourished patients before major surgery, those who require prolonged respiratory support. According to intake, if poor intake persists, 1. 3 to 5 days in severe malnutrition, 2. 5 to 7 days in mild or moderate malnutrition, 3. 7 to 10 days in well-nourished patients, parenteral nutrition should be advised. Parenteral nutrition. Two types according to duration. 1. Short term, 2. Long term. Short term parenteral nutrition is advised in conditions like bowel injury or bowel surgery, major trauma, burns, bowel diseases, severe malnutrition, severe pancreatitis, malabsorption, etc. 2. Long term parenteral nutrition. Prolonged intestinal failure, Crohn's disease, bowel resection are indicated for long-term parenteral nutrition. Sites of delivery of parenteral nutrition. Two sites are usually used, peripheral and central. First, we will see the peripheral. Peripheral is given in any one of the vein. Indication, short-term use, less than 10 to 14 days. Change the site of delivery every 48 hours. Next is central. Superior vena cava, right atrium, inferior vena cava are used. Indication, long-term use or short-term when peripheral solution cannot meet full nutritional needs or if peripheral route is not available. Parenteral nutrition can be continuous, that is 24 hours per day, or cyclical running, that is for a period of 8 hours in 18 to 24 hours of each day, or intermittent, that is on some days only. Parenteral nutrition solutions consist of carbohydrates, amino acids, lipids, compound amino acids with electrolytes, trace elements and vitamins. Feeding selection. It is based on certain factors like age, nutritional requirements, gastrointestinal function, clinical status, disease entity and cost. Complications due to parenteral nutrition include mechanical pneumothorax, malposition embolism, infections, sepsis, thrombophlebitis, fluid overload, electrolyte or mineral imbalance, hyper or hypoglycemic, overfeeding, hepatobiliary dysfunction, air embolism, and acid-base imbalance. Enteral nutrition. Enteral nutrition or tube feeding is a medical treatment of giving nutrition by passing a liquid diet through a tube into the stomach or intestines. Indications: anorexia associated with chronic illness, cancer, severe pancreatitis without pseudocyst or fistula complication, neurological impairment, unconsciousness, coma, head injury, etc. Acute metabolic stress in trauma and burns, inflammatory bowel disease, prematurity in infants, short gut, oral surgery, gastrointestinal tract surgery, dysphagia after a stroke, mouth or oropharyngeal disorder or obstruction due to cancer, etc. Contraindications. If a patient can meet nutritional requirements orally, early stages of short bowel syndrome, severe malabsorption, obstruction of the intestines, paralytic ileus, protracted vomiting or diarrhea, high output fistulas, acute severe pancreatitis, acute bowel ischemia with peritonitis, etc. Types of enteral nutrition. 1. Nasogastric tubes. 2. Nasojejunal tubes. 3. Percutaneous endoscopic gastrectomy tubes. 4. Percutaneous jejunostomy tubes. 1. Nasogastric tubes. Most commonly used delivery routes, but depend on adequate gastric emptying. They allow the use of hypertonic feeds, high feeding rates, and bolus feeding into the stomach reservoir. Tubes are easy to insert but are easily displaced. Second type, nasojejunal tubes. These reduce the incidence of gastroesophageal reflux and are useful in the presence of delayed gastric emptying. Post-pyloric placement can be difficult but may be aided by intravenous, prokinetic or fiber optic observation. 3. Percutaneous endoscopic gastrectomy tubes. They are inserted directly through the stomach wall endoscopically or surgically under antibiotic care. Indications: stroke, motor neuron disease, Parkinson's disease, esophageal cancer, etc. Contraindications: gastroesophageal reflux, previous gastric surgery, gastric ulceration or malignancy, gastric outlet obstruction, etc. Fourth one, percutaneous jejunostomy tubes. They permit early postoperative feeding. They are useful in patients at risk of reflux. They are inserted through the stomach into the jejunum using a surgical or endoscopic technique. This is difficult and has more complications. Complications of enteral nutrition. 1. Mechanical. Erosion, perforation, stenosis, fistula, pulmonary aspiration, etc. are some mechanical complications. 2. Metabolic. Hypertonic dehydration, hyperosmolarity, hyper or hypoglycemic conditions. 3rd one, infections. Sinusitis, otitis, aspiration pneumonia, necrotizing peritonitis, enteritis are some infectious complications. 4th one, gastrointestinal tract complications. Constipation, diarrhea, regurgitation, vomiting, abdominal fullness and distension are some gastrointestinal tract complications. So that's all for today. See you in the next class. Bye bye. Take care.